may certain event na parang cultural ata, natatanda mo yan, sa Manila. Binubok sa amin doon, tapos naka-gear na kami, usually pag pagtutugtog, di ba, yung normal gear namin. Sabi, sir, sige, mag-bass na kayo.
Sige, mag-bass na kayo.
So, sir, they're expecting na magbabarong ata kami.
Kasi
cultural siya. Hindi namin alam ba't nandun kami, binuklang kami doon. Tapos paglabas namin, alam mo yung parang sa states yung mga nasa countryside lang, biglang may mga naupuan. Yeah. So yung mga tao doon, nakaganoon. So it was a choice sa amin na, ano ba, tumagtutal, sasabi niyo, hindi, kung ano tayo, ganun tayo.
Pero, wrong crowd eh. Wrong crowd. Ako, the best, every time nagki-play kami sa Rockista.
Yeah, Rockista
Jam, Rockista Rakrakan series.
Yan,
The best yun.
Sure. The worst gigs are when a member isn't there.
Yeah.
Cause it's so different. Sometimes you play as a threesome, but it's
what?
But it's threesome. But it's hard. I guess we're just pretty attached with one another.
Oh.
That could be a good thing. That could be a bad thing.
It'd be nice if it's if it were mutual.
There was a time that we played without Army.
What? Yeah. When was this?
Sa Giho. Then we called our band.
Oh shit, yeah.
Why? What happened? Where was I?
I don't know.
Oh my god, wow. Oh, the best gig we had was in Singapore where we had to play for like 5 minutes and that was it. Then we stayed there for like...
Oh yeah, I wasn't there.
Yeah, he wasn't there. I guess that was, that makes it the best gig.
I was losing my passport.
Yeah.
And actually, for me, the best gigs are the more intimate ones, like the ones in Sa Giho.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Yeah, compared to the really big
it's
ones.
It's really dark and people.
And most of the time...
I mean, you don't see the people.
Yeah.
But you just hear them.
Yeah. Usually, those... Not the ones in Sa Giho.
Hmm.
The place is so packed. And the people are so close that you know what they're having
for lunch.
You
just kiss them.
Yeah.
Yeah, he wants to do that.
Kiss someday. Them. I don't kiss them.
Worst gig was November 17, 2007.
Ah, wala pa
ka nun. Kaya, dark days ba? Dark days. We played a show for a certain cigarette brand.
It was horrible on all fronts.
Yeah.
Like, sound wasn't great.
My guitar wasn't in tune. I couldn't tune it because it's like a not a really nice guitar.
The crowd was really like not feeling it.
Not feeling it. Actually feeling it a bit hostile. Right?
Yeah.
And the venue's a big stadium. Right?
Yeah, it's a big stadium venue. Yeah, it's like the Expo in Clark.
Yeah. It's not like a small bar gig. It's like a...
With a lot of like 60-year-old men.
Yeah, embarrassing.
Yeah, it's weird. It's like...
Best gig.
Huh? Best gig. Yeah, I like all our gigs. All our gigs are nice.
It just keeps getting better.
Best gig in November 17.
Yeah, because that was a turning point.
That was
seriously,
also the best gig.
Yeah, that was a turning point for the band. It was like that was back then because I didn't say anything like in between songs.
It was very supplants.
Also because I don't know. I'm just supplants and shy. Because I'm shy. So parang that was the day that I decided to actually say stuff while I'm on stage. Say stuff more than like the next song is gonna. The next song is that's all I would say before.
Yeah, so it was sort of a reaffirmation of our passion and our intent of going through with the whole band thing. Yeah, naging masigurado na tayo after. Parang pangit man pero sobrang ganyan to, guys, na natin.
Oh, nga,
diba? Yung mga ganun na feeling.
Yeah.
Masama nun, isa natin, no?
That was horrible. That was so bad.
Hindi kami tumugtog dahil may sakit. Yun na lang, oh. Bahala
okay,
na kayo
mag-gulat. Okay, okay.
Dahil may sakit. Kung sino, hindi natin alam. Pero hindi kami tumugtog. Yun yung worst gig.
Sharing the stage with Esperanza Spalding, we were privileged enough to do a back-to-back concert with her here in the Philippines. Back in 2009. It was pretty awesome because as everybody knows, Esperanza is she won Grammy, the Grammy for the best new artist, I think.
After
and, you know, she's nasty, and you know, being having that honor of share, you know, to share the stage with us. Quite a feat.
Worst gig was probably the gig we didn't get to play.
Yeah,
it was a Halloween gig.
Yep. Oh yeah, all right. Yeah,
it was a Halloween gig, and then
we were in
things that really fucked up. Costumes. Yeah, we were in perfect costumes. Yeah.
Actually, like that was the first time that everyone was in uniform.
And I was excited to play.
Yeah.
But that didn't happen because the event didn't really it didn't push through. It got cut off at some point.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then we all went home.
Yeah. In costume.
Yeah. In costume.
Yeah, with my nuts out. Outpost in Cebu. That was
That's one of our best gigs.
Fuck fashion.
That was fun.
But
best gig is
Outpost.
Yeah, no,
I think after that gig, we got like a different level of confidence as far as playing gigs.
Yeah,
it was our first out of town trip, and it turned out pretty good. We were all kind of nervous because I don't know. We had our apprehensions about playing the Cebu crowd.
Yeah.
We said, "Oh my God, maybe they don't get it. Maybe they'll hate us even more."
Yeah. Para sa akin yung best at saka worst ko yung nag-front kami sa Good Charlotte. Pareho yun.
Ha? Best and worst?
Oh, best and worst. Worst siya dahil wala na ako.
Wala nga na. Ay! Totally lasing.
Hindi. Best pa rin yun eh. Pero ano lang. Basta, ang dahil kong nagulat na tao nun eh. Tsaka, na, ewan ko kung papayag kayo dun. Isa rin yun sa dahilan kung ba't tayo pinakinggan na intriga sila sa pinagagawa ko eh. Parang,
good. Sa akin, best gig yung ano, Hong Kong natin.
Oo.
Kasi, although hindi maraming tao, pero parang intimate yung crowd dun eh. Tapos, you know, may connection talaga nung when we played. Tapos, worst, lahat ng may faulty equipment. Kasi, minsan, syempre yung tao, excited sila, tapos yung mga producers hindi pinagbuti yung production nung ano. So yun yung mga worst, diba? Yung mga out of town gigs ay may mga gumaka, ganun.
Yung mga ganun,
nasusunog yung amp.
When Daryl Palumbo and Manny of Glass Jaw came out and watched us.
So basically, nag-open kami sa Glass Jaw.
Yun,
diba? Parang sobrang moment na yun. For like, 2 or 3 songs sa set namin. Na yung una, nandito lang sila. Tapos napansin ko yung iba members nandun na sa likod sa may soundboard.
Oh my God!
It's probably the last one with my band. Shadow Malungkot. Oh, probably the one at the Music Museum. I think it was 2009 or 2008, but we played with a 35 or 40 piece orchestra. It was amazing. I got to play all of my songs. Thus, to hear them with an orchestra, iba yung kulay ng kanta.
Yung early years namin, yung sa Payanig sa Pasig.
Yeah, one of the
back in 95. Yun, yung one of the big gigs. Kasi at that time, medyo ano pa eh, may mga traces of yung mga Punks Not Dead attitude pa ng mga crowd. We used to see people crawling up the walls of Intramuros just to get inside the venue. We even saw the gates of a certain part of Intramuros get torn apart by the kids who wants to get in. Tapos yun yung the only gig na may bumagsak na ganyang kalaking bakal sa harapan ko. I thought na siguro kung nag-move forward pa ako ng one step, baka sa ulo ko tumama yun eh. Tapos yun nga, yung set namin na-cut kasi talagang yung nagpapatayan sila.
Papulungan, those guys raising their flags.
Marami din kami naaalala, yung mga Mosh Pit Sundays na gigs, mga throwdown na gigs ngayon. Memorable naman every gig sa amin. Kasi yun nga, since very rare na rin yung time na nakakatugtog ang Sky Church, nagiging memorable din lahat. May mga nangyayari na...
So, sometimes we play as a surprise guest.
What usually happens, like, if ever na Robert is there, tapos Intolerant is playing there, yun, he'd usually come on stage, tapos we'll do like 3 songs for the kids, ganun. So, nagiging memorable siya. Pero yun nga, very rare na rin talaga nangyayari yun. Kasi nga, may kanya, we each have our own bands now.
Ano yan, yung palito bar, pare?
Wala ko na namin.
Yun yung pinaka-worst sa akin kasi sa amin. Kasi yung set namin noon na medyo pinagmamadaliin nila kami. Na hindi pa kami ready, pinapatugtog na kami.
Talagang bad day talaga siya eh. Bad night, bad day. Actually, inabot pa yung the following day. So, isip namin, ay, malas na tong gig na to. Mag-enjoy na lang tayo. Pauwi na lang sa Manila.
To summarize lang, ano, yung uminom kami, nagkaroon ng away, nadamay kami.
Napunta kami sa presinto.
Tapos, hindi, yung nadamay, yung nadamay.
Pinapas ako ng bote.
yung nadamay lang kasi kami, nung nadamay kami, kami pa yung
naging masama.
Kasi may mga tattoo sila rin.
Ayun, tapos yun, matig na kami makulong. Ayun, so.
Tinampot kami ng mobil.
Yung worst gig para sa amin ever. Kasi si
Ariel kasi. Ako para sa akin, SummerSlam sa akin.
Sa'yo. Oo pala, first big event namin, SummerSlam.
SummerSlam.
Pulp SummerSlam. Pwede bang dalawa yung best gig?
Hindi.
Shadows Fall. Open talaga for Shadows Fall. Kasi sobrang big deal sa amin yan eh. Kasi, syempre diba, parang Grammy nominated metal band yung so, Shadows Fall. So may kami, kasama kami sa napiling banda para mag-open.
Justin Down ng taos!
Every gig's the worst. We're the worst band.
Never was.
Davao, the gig that yeah, the gig that never was. The worst gig we can remember is when we did and, have to play.
It was supposed to be in Davao. But
yeah,
right when there was
some random chick just said, "Hey, I'm gonna take you to Davao. I'm gonna pay you good money to play in my area." Then suddenly she has no money. We locked ourselves up. We decided not to play RJ gig in San Pablo Laguna. Actually, that was
the first.
Most memorable. But
wala ka pa na.
Paul and Tatel,
we aren't
members yet.
Members yet that time, but yeah.
Even had dual vocals, alal. It's like a new school hardcore.
And the despised icon.
It was memorable in the sense that, looking back, it was just a very humble goal that. We just wanted to play and see people slam to our songs. What's fascinating about that is it's our first actual band practice earlier that day with me. No. That's my first time. But that was our first official gig and it was memorable. That
Bacolod was fun too.
Yeah. One more memorable gig was
the streaker.
There was a circle pit in Bacolod and there was this kid.
He was a streaker.
He was wearing a pair of sneakers with no clothes
just
on.
Just balls.
Just balls like, going like that.
So that's a Viking love.
It was Viking love.
You see the contrast of people headbanging the right and left, the middle. The mosh pit just separated into two. And there was this kid jumping up and down, his balls going like that.
I also like the one in Katipunan. the boy with the broken hand.
He was slamming to The Art of Letting Go.
He was slamming to our lamest hit, The Art of Letting Go.
That was the heaviest song ever.
And he fucking broke his hand.
He was like that. You're carrying it outside.
Oh man, sorry for you guys.
What the fuck happened to that kid? He was slamming The Art of Letting Go. I love this interview.
Sa the burst yung ano sa Dubai nung tumugtog tayo ng nakakulong si Del. Puta na, ang hirap magsaya nun sa harap nila tapos oh shit, nakakulong siya. May sinundang kaming banda, parang show band na tatlong matatabang babae. Magaling naman sila tapos malilibog yung biro nila. So tuwan-tuwa yung mga lasing na nanonood. Sabay kami yung intermission. Una binigyan kami ng tissue nung malaking lalaki para ko. Tumigil kayo, hindi namin kayo gusto ha. Pagtingin nga, wala naman nakasulat sa tissue. Tutog lang kami kasi bayad kami nun eh. Sabi naman, sunod na bigay, basta ang tissue na walang sulat. Pag di ka bubahat, babarilin kita. Sabi naman, babarilin daw kami. Hindi, okay lang yan. Sabi nga naman.
Gago ka ba? Hindi, ikaw tumugtog dito.
Tinamakan kami, hassle kaya yun. Again, hindi na kami tumugtog. Tapos, pinalabas din yung lalaki. Ganun sa taxi.
mapaki yun sa namin, kaya lang umahabol na natatakot din. We were playing this golden stage, ganyan. Golden. May band is playing golden drums, golden guitars, I'm singing a golden mic. Suddenly I wake up. So, I'm that dream. I thought that was the best. Madami kami mga memorable gig yung mga...
Unang Summer Slam.
Unang Summer Slam.
Saya nun.
Papunta kami sa venue, madaming shit na nangyari. Yung kotse ni Puto, nalagyan ng diesel nung nag-away kami nila boards. Pagdating namin, maghihiwalay na tayo, no, bago tumugtog. Nung malapit na kami sa... Ang laki ng stage! Ang ganda! Sabi, I love you!
Nagyakapag kami lima.
Nagyakapag namin tumugtog sa ina namin nun, unang Summer Slams. Okay na. Isa rin yung nakatutog kami sa ibang bansa na nakakatawa kasi dati. Wala kami mga... Kami ni Boards, ID namin, fake IDs lang kasi wala talaga tayong mga kwentang citizen ng Pilipinas eh. Gumagawa lang kami fake ID para may ID. Tapos nung nakapunta kami ng ibang bansa, sa Marinduque.